As that summer came to an end, the hot days felt colder, and the nights were gloomier. The one that hits me brings chills to my spine and goosebumps, reminding me of the same feeling I felt on that roller coaster back in the early days of summer. School felt like something more than just learning. It felt like home. Now it kills me knowing that the desk next to me lies empty, waiting for the next student to come along. No one even matters to me anymore. Those memories, those images you keep in your head that you wish you could relive, are gone. Somewhere in space, somewhere in time. Those were the days, I say to myself. Those days are over. No more theme parks in the summer, no more movies on Tuesday, no more laughter or joy during math class. October 8th was the worst day of my life. My best friend was killed in an accident, driving the car down the freeway as a truck came and flipped him over. I still wonder what went through his head on those last moments. I heard once that the greatest things ever experienced in one's life are the ones that flash upon thee in their last moments on earth. The days after his death, I saw a door, a red door, speaking to me, calling out to me. Although I was frightened of what I was seeing, living in a black and white world, it was the only thing that stood out to me, the only thing that had color, the only thing I cared for at the time. It seemed nice and caring, reminding me of my friend George. A light surrounded it as it glowed like a star. I walked closer to it, feeling a wave of warmth comforting me. It was then when I looked up, opening the door wide, and knowing who it was. In that moment, color began to fade in as sadness escaped me. I reached in as the last greatest experience flashed upon me in that last minute. And now, a world of more great moments to come lie here in another void with my friend George.